Hey everybody, Beard Report Tech here. If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. I am going to be filling up my 1234YF portion of my dual machine over here, and I was just gonna go through the process of that with you. I got my new bottle here, which is $600 for the 10-pound cylinder, so I can fill my holding tank so I can finish my fleet Tahoe. So let's get into it. Set up, I am on 1234YF. So I'm gonna go to settings, and then I'm gonna go to tank filling. And then it's gonna ask me how much I wanna do. I'm just gonna say 5 pounds. Hit enter. And then it's gonna ask me to connect my tank to my 134A, which is on this side, blue hose, which is the low side. My high side's already connected to the vehicle still, but the valve is off. This is my 134A, this is my 1234YF, excuse me. So let's go over here and get the tanks set up. The very expensive tank, you see, 1234YF. This is a 10 pounder, it's like $599. You do need the adapter that goes onto here. First, I gotta cut that off. And one of my subscribers may recognize this knife. Trouble, thank you, I use it all the time. Peel this bad boy off of here. And what I'm doing is I will connect this to the machine over there and it will pull from this tank and put it into the holding tank that is on the machine. And they really wrap these things, and I hate them. Now that that's done, I apologize. Pull that off, the adapter, screw it on. And does it look like I'm going backwards? That's lefty loosey, righty tighty. Well, I am going the opposite way because the tank is upside down, obviously. You don't have to put it on with an impact gun, but we don't want any leaks. So we're just gonna snug it. That's it, snug. And if you look, this end up for gas, when you flip it over, this end up for liquid. So when I go put it on the machine, this end's gonna be facing up. Take that. Connect, open, then I'm gonna turn it upside down and open this. Turn the knob. Kinda hard to do with one hand. Button. Let's see, the low side pressure went up. It's going to take a sample of that to make sure it's pure refrigerant.
It's going to take some Freon. You'll hear it suck some out. It'll test it, tell me if it's good to go. This 1234YF takes a long time. It is so touchy. That is not the correct date. See what I mean by this 1234YF, it's very touchy, it's very sensitive, it takes forever. And it should tell me 100% refrigerant, no air, anything like that. See? 100%. And then it's going to start. See the pounds, 64.0, 63. That's nope, excuse me. This one, my bad. So it's gonna do its thing and then I'll finish the vehicle. So that is the tank filling process, so I can put it in the holding tank so I can service other vehicles. And that one was completely empty, so it didn't pull anything out, so there was nothing in the holding tank to put back into the vehicle. I fixed that, but now I gotta fill up the tank so I can put Freon back in the vehicle. Anyway, when you do pull Freon out of a vehicle, it holds it in that exact same tank. And then when you get done doing what you're doing and you recharge it, it basically takes that out. But there was nothing in there except for the 1 pound that I put in there from my other empty tank. Anyway, I love you guys and I'll see you on the next one.